How do we solve geometric progression without using the conventional formula, just using our calculator? That is what we're going to discuss today. Sa pagpasok ng COVID, ang lahat ng school at review centers ay natigil. Liban lang, of course, sa Padilla Review Center. Ang lahat ay nag-migrate sa online. Iba-ibang pakulo, iba-ibang style, ang mga estudyante sa pagpili, lalong nalito, lalong naguluhan. Pero para bigyan kayo ng mas clear idea on how we do it actual in our online review, we created this channel para nakikita nyo ano talaga ang mangyayari, paano namin ginagawa sa loob ng Padilla Review Center Online. All links are found below this video. But before we begin with our discussion today, please don't forget to visit and to also like our FB page, Padilla Review Center. Nasa baba po ang link. Subscribe na rin po kayo dito sa YouTube channel namin. Huwag niyong kalilimutang i-click ang notification bell, choose all para lagi po kayong updated and notified sa lahat ng post namin. Para po sa inyong lahat ng nagre-review ito at nag-aaral ng engineering. Pati po yung mga BS math, lahat po nang nagtitake ng math. Pero hindi po limited sa math. Buong civil engineering specifically ang didiscuss namin kasama po yung ibang subjects sa ibang engineering, mga common subjects like mechanics and strength. So kung may mga request po kayo na problem, ipadala lang po dito sa YouTube channel namin and then isha-shoutout po namin yung kung kanino nanggaling yung problem na yon and hindi lang isha-shoutout, isosolve. Geometric progression are series of numbers with common ratio or common multiplier. To identify whether a series of numbers are in geometric progression, all you need to do is divide them backwards. For example, 2, 6, 18, 54, so on and so forth. 54 divided by 18 is 3. 18 divided by 6 is 3. 6 divided by 2 is 3. There is a common ratio. So these are in geometric progression with common ratio or common multiplier of 3. You get it? So, for example, we are asked to find the 20th term in this geometric progression. How do we find it? Using our calculator, not the conventional formula, which if you studied mathematics a long time ago, so few years back, most likely you already had forgotten the formula. But your calculator has the formula, a little bit variation, no? So, all you need to do here is to use the function mode stat. So, press mode stat, that is mode 3, you'll see there an option. If in an arithmetic progression, we use the linear number 2, in geometric progression, we will use the number 6. That is AB to the exponent, meaning AB to the X. The full equation actually is Y equals. This is the function of X that is expressing the value of Y. Now, I want to emphasize here that here, your X here will play the subscript of the term, while Y here will represent the term itself. For example, we represent the term as a, so this would be a sub x. So if x is 1, this is a1. If this x is 2, this is a2. Now, b here will be the common ratio. And ab will be the first term. Anyway, you don't need to memorize all of them. You just have to follow our solution that follows here. So, find the 20th term in this GP. So, all you need to do is mode 3, 6. So, you will see a matrix there of X and Y. So, enter the first X, Y. So, we know A1, we know A2. This is our A1, this is our A2, right? So, our known subscripts are 1 and 2. So, under X in your calculator, you press 1 equals, then 2 equals, then right arrow key, up, up. So your cursor will be across 1. So enter now A1, which is 2. So A1, which is 2. A2 which is 6. A2 which is 6 equals. So you had entered this data 2 and 6. You get it? All right. So then you press cancel all so that the screen of your calculator will be reset. Then let us find A20. So 20 is the subscript, right? We are looking for A20. So 20 is the subscript. So press in your calculator 20, no? And then you press up regression, that is 8. Okay? So and then up 8, we are looking for, this is an X, we are looking for the Y. So you choose 5. Okay? So up 8, then 5. 5 is for caret Y because we are looking for the Y corresponding to 20. So press equals. So you'll get here. 2, 3, 2, 4, 5, 2, 2, 9, 3, 4. This is your A20. You follow? You get it? Now, what about if we are asked to find the sum of first 10 terms? So, para sa sum, gagamitin naman natin yung summation. So, that would be up to, right? Okay? So, however, we need the equation of the geometric progression. The equation in your calculator is a, b to the x. We need a, we need b. Okay? So, if you do not know what is the common ratio in this, that is 3, so let us solve them. Paano natin so-solven yung a and b in the equation? Kasi equation ang kailangan, a, b to the x. Okay? So, again, you just press CA para ma-reset. And then, let us solve the A. All you need to do is press up 8. So, just press up 8. For A, you press 1. So, equals. So, you'll get here, your A will be equal to, the display will be 0.666666. Then, you just press fraction to decimal key. You'll get here a value equal to 2. Notice that the fraction is given in this symbol. So, A is 2/3. You get it? Now, press CA again in order to solve B, then up 8, 2. 2 is for B, right? So, then press equals. Your calculator will give you 3. You follow? So, therefore, we are ready to solve our summation of first 10 terms. So, for the summation of first 10 terms, we just apply up to. But you've got to exit first sa mode stat. Kailangan natin ng computation lang. How to exit? Mode 1. Okay? So, just enter mode 1. In order to be back to computation, then up 2. So, mode 1. Ito yung pang-exit sa mode stat. Naka-mode stat kasi tayo. Hindi gagana yung summation sa mode stat. So, kaya, balik ka lang muna sa mode 1, then up 2. So, once you press up 2, ma-activate yung summation. So, your calculator will ask you for the equation. The equation is a, b to the x. Your A is 2/3 times your B is 3 to the alpha X. Then, right arrow key. Then, yung X mo dito is from 1 to 10 because we need the first 10 terms. So, you press your calculator here and you'll get here, processing 59,048. Naintindihan? Kahit wala yung formula mo, pwede mong masolve yung problem. You can still solve the problem even without the formula. You get it? You get it? Okay. Paano naman kung sum of infinite geometric progression? So, our solution will still be the same. We just have to solve first the equation of the geometric progression. The equation is ab to the x, or y is ab to the x. We need a, we need b. So, I said before that b is the common ratio, ab is the first term. But what if you do not know that, or you had forgotten that? Because your calculator shows the equation, so let us just solve AB from what we know. Okay, so again, you just have to be back to your mode stat in order to solve A and B. So this is your A1, this is your A2. X1, X2, Y1, Y2, right? So go to your mode stat. So mode stat. So that is mode 3. Then 6. Okay? So, mode 3, 6. That is for A, B to the X. No? A, B to the X or A, B exponent. So, lalabas yung matrix natin ng X and Y. So, enter 1 equals, 2 equals, then right arrow key, up, up. So, it's now across the 1. So, enter 2 equals, then 1 equals. Then, press CA in order to reset the screen. So, and then, we are asked here to solve A. We're not looking for A20 or A10 or whatsoever. We just need A and B. So, again, after pressing CA, just press up 8, 1. Up 8, 1 is for the missing A, right? Okay? So, then, press equals. So, what you are going to get here for your A is going to be 4, right? Right. Okay. Now, in here now, up 8, 1 is 4. And then, press CA again in order to solve B. So, for B, you press up 8, 2. This is for B. Then, equals. It will show you your B. Your B is going to be 0.5 or 1 half. So, therefore, we are ready now to solve our summation, but exit from mode stat. Press again mode 1. Then, we are ready now to use summation. Up 2. Once you press the summation symbol, this one, you enter our equation. Our equation is going to be equal to AB to the X. It's A 4 times B 0.5 to the X. Right arrow key, then X equals 1. Tama? This is infinite terms. So, this is supposed to be to infinity, but your calculator cannot handle infinity. So, this is 30 will give you a fairly good answer. You get it? Okay, anyway, the 31st term and so on will just be almost negligible. Okay? So, therefore, computing it, press equals now. And your calculator will show 3.99999999996. Or this is practically 4. Kulang ng konti dahil meron ka namang tinanggal na 31st term to infinite term, no? But the answer is fairly accurate. Do you follow? You get it? So, yan po yung geometric progression. I encourage you to enroll in our calculator tricks training. Or if you are a civil engineering student, I really encourage you, if you are still college, to enroll in our review in advance. The beauty of this, if you enroll in our online review in advance, which is a lot better than physical review, you will be able to have an advanced preparation and makakatulong sa school nyo. And at the same time, pag nag-board exam ka, dahil advanced ang preparation mo, you have a strong chance of topping the board exam. Okay? And once you repeat the review, you just have to pay a very minimal fee para sa pag-ulit ng review. You get it? So, hindi na buo ang babayaran mo kapag ka nag-ulit ka ng review. Meron kaming top-notcher, second year pa lang, nag-review na. Ang tagal niyang nag-review, bali halos 5 years. Dahil 4 years siyang nag-review sa amin, pagkatapos, pag-take ng board exam, he was second placer. Meron kami na nag-enroll, taga CIT, no? Third year pa lang, naka-enroll na sa amin. So, bali, 3.5 years siyang nag-review. So, dahil 3 taon man siya nag-review sa amin, then 1.5 year pa na nag-review nung graduate siya. So, he's a first placer in the board exam. So, I really encourage you, kayong mga college, to really advance, enroll in advance sa board exam. Okay? Or dito sa review natin. Tignan nyo yung online. Mas maganda pa siya kaysa sa actual review. Kasi sa online namin, paulit-ulit mong nare-review yung mga topics. Paulit-ulit mong nare-review yung diniscuss. Nakuha nyo? Okay? So, kita-kita tayo ulit. Hanggang sa muli.